Hello everyone, let's start with sewage treatment. So sewage treatment can be achieved with the help of various methods. These methods can be physical, chemical and of biological nature. So in a treatment plant, in a typical treatment plant, a combination of all these three methods is used to achieve the treatment of sewage. So we can see the classification of sewage depending upon whether we are using physical methods or chemical and biological methods. So the basic classification is between this, if it is unit operation or unit process. So if physical forces are applicable in the removal of impurities, then we term that particular method as unit operation. So the various treatment methods that come under unit operation, we can write some of these, that is screening will come under your unit operation, then sedimentation, grit chamber, these are all your unit operations. Whereas if chemical or biological forces are applied, or chemical and biological methods are applied for the removal of impurities such as organic matter, then we term that particular method of treatment as unit process. So the various methods, that some of them we'll write here, so that come under here are oxidation pond, then you can take trickling filter, activated sludge process. These are examples of unit processes. That is your basic classification. Then we can see what are the various steps in which treatment is given to sewage. So initially there is preliminary treatment. Preliminary treatment. So preliminary treatment is done to remove floating impurities or floating materials, we can write. Apart from that, some inorganic settleable solids. So what are these are removed in your preliminary treatment, so that the further load on the treatment plant will be reduced if we remove them initially. That is floating materials such as your wood can be there, or some paper, or some these settleable solids like metal and bones can be there, glass can be there. So all these will be removed in your preliminary treatment. So the treatment that come under this one, that is screens or grit chambers, that is basically here we are applying unit operations, or the physical forces are predominant in case of preliminary treatment. That's how you can remember it. Skimming tank also. So these are all your preliminary treatment methods. After that, next step would be primary treatment. So sometimes whatever we have covered in preliminary treatment, these methods are termed under primary treatment also. So you should not confuse. I mean, preliminary and primary treatment both depend upon these unit operations, that is physical forces are predominant. In case of preliminary treatment, you can remember one thing, that is here no organic solids are removed, no organic matter. Whereas in case of primary treatment, one of the example is sedimentation. So this sedimentation, if preliminary treatment is given, then your inorganic settleable solids will be removed in preliminary treatment such as grit chamber, whereas organic solids will be removed, I mean not all the organic solids, but some of them will be removed in primary sedimentation. So around 60 to 70% of suspended solids are removed in this primary sedimentation, and that is your primary treatment. So whatever solids are removed here, so these will be organic solids if we have given preliminary treatment. So these settled solids have to be sent to a sludge digestion tank so that this organic matter can be stabilized. This we can see later also. So just to give you brief idea. And if preliminary treatment is not given, then in this primary sedimentation, both organic as well as inorganic particles will settle, but it is not preferable because it will increase the load on the sludge digestion unit. After that preliminary treatment, primary treatment, we have secondary treatment. So that is, after primary treatment, whatever sewage we get, that will be sent to next unit, and these come under your secondary treatment units. So in these units, mostly biological treatment is given. That is, it is done by the active microbial mass, or we can say active microbial bacteria. So the methods, what is removed here? So soluble and colloidal organic matter. Colloidal organic matter, these will be removed in your secondary treatment units. So as I said, it contains a large amount of active microbial bacteria. And what are the processes or the methods? So trickling filter and your anaerobic lagoon. As well as oxidation pond, or you can take ASP, that is activated sludge process. These all come under secondary treatment. So most of the treatment plants are given, they give the treatment up to this stage, but in some other cases, last stage, that is tertiary treatment, it is also given. So it is mostly used when there are some of the inorganic impurities such as phosphorus has to be removed and nitrogen has to be removed, because if we leave the water with phosphorus and nitrogen in some stream, then it accelerates the growth of algae. So it is preferable in some cases to remove these also. These are inorganic matters. So for that, denitrification has to be done. And apart from that, tertiary treatment is given when this water which we are releasing from this wastewater treatment plant, after this point, it has to be again collected for drinking water treatment. Drinking water purposes, then that waste has to be necessarily given this tertiary treatment. So in that case, some other methods which are used, so adsorption with activated carbon, this can also be given as a treatment, and disinfection can also be done, disinfection to kill the pathogens, because further we are going to use similar sources for the drinking water purposes. So disinfection has to be given. So these are the processes, a brief overview of the processes that are used in case of sewage treatment. So now let's see little about these. For this sedimentation, different types of settlings are there. Types of settling. So I will not take complete all these grid chamber and primary sedimentation, because theory is similar to what we have already seen in water treatment. So I'll just cover, after this video we will start with trickling filter and then activated sludge process, and later whatever is necessary that we can cover. So these different types of settling are there in case of sedimentation, that we can see here in brief. That is type 1, type 2, type 3 and type 4 settling. So type 1 is your discrete settling. Discrete settling means what we have seen in plain sedimentation, that is, there are no interparticle forces, or we can say a particle and all the particles are settling freely. So that is, it will happen in case of if sand is there and grit is there. So these settle very easily without causing any hindrance to other particles, and that come under your type 1 settling. Then you have type 2 settling, and which is known as flocculent settling. So flocculent settling, you can obviously understand with the name also. So these flocs will form. Initially we have these colloidal particles, but they form the floc, and so their mass will increase, and then they will settle at a very high rate or with a very high velocity. So but here some interparticle forces are working, you can see. So particles form flocs to settle, and then these, due to formation of these flocs, this mass will be more, so this settling rate is higher. This is your type 2 settling. Then we have type 3 settling, and that is your hindered or zone settling. So flock formation, it happens because we have already seen when we add some coagulant, this discrete settling will happen if we have these bigger particles like sand and grit. And after that, in case of secondary sedimentation tank, what happens in the lower zone of the sedimentation tank, these between these flocs also or particles also, interparticle forces act. So this is one floc or one particle, and another point we have another particle. So some interparticle forces will be acting so that the relative position of these particles, they do not change. I mean, they will settle as a whole bigger mass. So this whole unit will be settling together. It will happen like that because some interparticle forces are acting. So you can see, I mean, we can write mass of particles subside as a whole due to interparticle forces. Then you have the last one, that is type 4 settling, which happens in the lowest zone, lowest part of a secondary sedimentation tank, we can write. So type 4 settling, which is known as compression settling. So as we go below this hindered zone or zone settling, in this lower part, these particles will come in contact with each other and they will form a structure. They are in contact with each other and they will have some pores in between. So a structure is formed. Structure is formed, and any further settling can only be done when you are adding some more mass of particles. And that is obviously happening. More particles will be coming down and it will add to the, I mean, it will increase the load on this structure. So because of this increased load, further settling will be happening. That is your type 4 settling. So it forms a structure, and in this zone, particle concentration is very high, and the further settling happens due to only compression of structure. So as already I have told, this happens in the lowest part of secondary or 2 degree sedimentation tank. And apart from that, in sludge digestion tank also it happens. So this is just a brief overview about different treatment methods and about these settling zones. Now after this, we'll start with the more important topics, that is your trickling filter and activated sludge process. Thank you.